directors had a completely different approach to those movies, you know, which is interesting because the story is obviously a book ends and then it picks up, you know, the next moment is the next book, you know, so there's a unity to that, and there's obviously a unity in the writing, both of the books and the scripts, you know, but within that, within those constraints, each director has done something very different, and what I was excited by was that the fourth movie especially seemed really different from the others, and then the fifth is very different from the fourth, so it is a chance to put your mark on it. It's like a great Hollywood romantic melodrama combined with a really cool, intense horror movie, you know? Both of those ideas kind of clashing with each other, and I think actually turning it into something that's kind of unique. I remember actually going in to talk to all the folks for the first time, and it was like, wow, there are big things to figure out here. Sex for the first time. Talking wolves. Imprinting, you know? That's just in the first film, you know. But yeah, there are big challenges, you know, because it's about taking something that's written as a fantasy and actually bringing the moviegoer along to the degree that they believe in it, you know. And some of these ideas are pretty out there, you know. But that again was what was fun about it, to try to figure out how to create a universe where you would go along for that ride. Kristen and Rob, everyone's coming into themselves, you know, coming into their own, you know, and I thought there was, you know, just this great ease between them, you know, and a sense of confidence that was really enjoyable. He has all these complicated pressures, and he decides to listen to nobody but himself. You know, he, for his own reasons, decides he's going to protect the Cullens. He's going to break from his pack, and he's alone. You know, and it's this rite of passage for him. And I felt the same way about Taylor. You know, he has some of the most emotionally powerful scenes in the movie, and I thought he did them beautifully.
Breaking Down One is coming of age, really. It's leaving home and becoming an adult, being on your own for the first time, being married, which is very grown up. It's a very grown up story. It's a very adult story. It just happens to be happening to an 18-year-old. In Breaking Down One, initially, It seems ideal. It seems perfect. It is the perfect romance finally coming to the perfect romance finally coming together. But as with all happy endings, as with all marriages, there are complications, and there is no such thing as happily ever after. Conflict number one in the marriage is Bella wants sex. She wants to be have the full human experience, as she says, and. Edward is far too concerned for her safety. He wants her to stay alive.